Good morning, my friends. This is the first of our televised masses, and I'm so grateful to Aboriginal television and Larrakia radio for the generosity in the gift they are giving to us, providing this service. We live in unusual times, and we need to use whatever is available to us to convey the message of hope that Jesus gives to us. So we start our Sunday Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. While this Mass is being televised during the week, every Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, at the same time as this Mass is being televised, I will actually be celebrating Mass in this cathedral at the same time. So please be aware that while you are watching this Mass, it's actually, there's Mass being celebrated exactly at the same time. On this journey of Lent, we continue to acknowledge our sins, but more importantly, the mercy and the love of God. So we pray, loving God, you are with us in good times and in bad times. Lord, have mercy. Loving God, you turn to good everything for those who love you. Christ, have mercy. Loving God, you forgive our sins and you help us to make fresh starts all the time. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us into healing and life everlasting. So we pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same love with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed himself over to death. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now we listen to the first scripture reading.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord says this, I am now going to open your graves. I mean to raise you from your graves, my people, and lead you back to the soil of Israel. And you will know that I am the Lord, when I open your graves and raise you from your graves, my people. And I shall put my spirit in you, and you will live. And I shall resettle you on your soil, and you will know that I, the Lord, have said and done this. It is the Lord who speaks. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, with the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. There is mercy. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleading. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. If you, O Lord, should mark our guilt, Lord, who would survive? But with you is found forgiveness. For this we revere you. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. My soul is waiting for the Lord. I count on his word. My soul is longing for the Lord, more than watchmen for daybreak. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Because with the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption, Israel indeed he will redeem from all its iniquity. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. People who are interested only in unspiritual things can never be pleasing to God. Your interests, however, are not in the unspiritual, but the spiritual, since the Spirit of God has made his home in you. In fact, unless you possessed the Spirit of Christ, you would not belong to him. Though your body may be dead, it is because of sin. But if Christ is in you, then your spirit is life itself, because you have been justified. And if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, then he who raised Jesus from the dead will give life to your own mortal bodies through his spirit living in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. The sisters, Martha and Mary, sent this message to Jesus. Lord, the man you love is ill. On receiving the message, Jesus said, this sickness will not end in death, but in God's glory. And through it, the Son of Man will be glorified. Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. Yet when he learned that Lazarus was ill, he stayed where he was for 2 more days before saying to his disciples, "Let us go to Judea." On arriving, Jesus found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days already. When Martha heard that Jesus had come, she went to meet him. Jesus remained sitting in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though they die, they will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die." "Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into the world." Jesus said, in great distress, with a sigh that came straight from the heart, "Where have you put him?" They said, "See how much he loved him." But there were some who remarked, "He opened the eyes of the blind man. Could he not have prevented this man's death?" Still sighing, Jesus reached the tomb. It was a cave with a stone to close the opening. Jesus said, "Take the stone away." Martha said to him, "Lord, by now he will smell. This is the 4th day. Jesus replied, "Have I not told you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took the stone away. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing my prayer. I knew indeed that you always hear me, but I speak for the sake of these who stand around me, so they may believe it was you who sent me." When he had said this, he cried in a loud voice, "Lazarus, here, come out." The dead man came out, his feet and hands bound with bands of stuff and cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him, let him go free." Many of the people who came to visit Mary and had seen what he did, believed in him. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, in different ways, we are all affected by what is going on in our country here in Australia as a result of the coronavirus, but also around the world. So many aspects of our life have had to change, disturbed. Many of you are being affected by financial troubles and pressures as a result of not being able to work, not to work the normal hours. Many of you are finding themselves confined at home. Others are fearful and scared. Some of you may even know others in your family or friends who have been affected by what's going on. You've been personally touched, affected. However, consciously or unconsciously, we are all affected by what is happening. In today's gospel, Jesus raises a man from the dead back to life, an amazing phenomenon. Lazarus was truly dead, and 4 days later, by the power of God, he is alive again. Did you hear those words from Jesus when he came out? Unbind him. Set him free. Set him loose. My friends, what binds us? What stops us from being our true self? Is it fear? Is it grief? Is it self-doubt? Is it relationship issues? What stops us from being our true self? We can often see things that happen in our life as interruptions. The interruptions of this virus. The interruptions of death. I was just talking before I started celebrating this mass to my cousin in Adelaide. My young cousin got killed last week in a motorbike accident. A horrible thing. A young man in his prime, 30 years of age. Suddenly, full of life, and then next minute, he's gone. But is he really gone? Today's gospel reminds us that when we die, we don't go. We just go ahead. We don't stop existing. We live now in a new way. So whether it's grief or other perceived interruptions in our life, the reminder is that God is still there. And the promise is that God will turn to good everything for those who love him, even death itself. Look at the death of Jesus that brought about resurrection and hope for all of us. My friends, we are never alone. God is always there for us. So please take some time every day to talk to God. Tell him about what's happening in your life. The fears, the grief, the sadness, the anger, whatever is there, name it. The temptation is, when we are feeling burdened, that we start looking inwards. My friends, let us not fall into that temptation. Let us not become selfish because of fear. Let's keep in mind the needs of others as well. There's been hoarding and maybe even some discourtesy and even some violence because of this effect of the virus in the lives of people. Let's beware of not falling into the trap. Let's continue being considerate, thoughtful about others. And finally, my friends, we remember the words of Jesus. I am with you always, even unto the end of time. We are never alone. Let's have a quiet moment, and then we will profess the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My friends, we now pray for our needs and the needs of the whole church. We pray for Pope Francis and all church leaders that they continue to get the strength and wisdom of the Holy Spirit to guide the people of God. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. For all world leaders, that they work together for the good of humanity, for the common good of all at this time. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. We continue to pray for those who are suffering grief because of this, the death of loved ones as a result of this virus, and all who grieve. Give them the consolation of the promise of life everlasting. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the medical staff everywhere in the world who are overburdened as a result of this virus, give them the strength that they need. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all of us, that we face this time with courage, love, and consideration for all, Lord, hear us. Lord, hear our prayer. Dear God, we put these prayers before you and all that's in our hearts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we move into the Eucharist, the blessing of the bread and wine, which will become Jesus among us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask you to receive us, and I please with sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my own sins. Wash away our sins. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice from our hands to the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in us, your servants, the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the work of this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as a true human being, he wept for Lazarus, his friend, and as Eternal God, raised him from the tomb. Just as taking pity on the human race, he leads us by sacred mysteries to new life. Through him, the hosts of angels adores you and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, so that sins may be for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, all the clergy, and the people your Son has gained for you. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray for the ones we know and love who have died. And for all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. And wherever we are now, let's turn to each other and in the right manner, offer each other the sign of peace. Peace to you all. Peace to all. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite you at this time to make what we call a spiritual communion or communion by desire. I remind you what that means. Because you cannot physically attend Mass and receive Holy Communion, you can tell God in your own words that you desire to receive Him in Holy Communion. And you will receive the same grace that you would receive if you are actually at Holy Communion. Let's have a quiet moment now while you do this in your heart. Let us pray. Strengthened by the blessings of your sacraments, we pray, O Lord, that through them we may constantly be cleansed of our faults and by following Christ, hasten our step upwards towards you through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear friends, I'm about to give the final blessing now. And remember, while you are watching this, even though this has been pre-recorded, I am actually celebrating Mass in the same place at the same time. So continue making those spiritual communions. Continue making time to pray in your own homes, the rosary, the office of the church, reading the scriptures. And continue being mindful to be kind to each other and to keep mind the needs of others as well as our own needs. These are stressful times, and sometimes we can react in a way we normally don't. So through prayer and remembering that God is with us, let's keep all doing the right thing with the grace of God. The Lord be with you all, and may the peace and the blessing of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain always with you. Amen. Let us go and live the gospel. Thanks be to God. God bless you all. We'll be here again next Sunday at 9 o'clock. God bless you.
No.